Evening, everyone. So today we start arrangement of capacitors. Okay. So in arrangement of capacitors, my first heading is series arrangement. So suppose we arrange or we connect three capacitors C1, C2, C3 in series with a capacitor, with a battery V. So what happened first of all? In series arrangement, same charge flows through all capacitors. This is the first thing. Second thing is that as this one is a battery, so the amount of charge supplied by the battery is equal to amount of charge received by the battery. Now, if V is the total voltage, then we can say this voltage is voltage by the first capacitor, voltage by the second capacitor, voltage by the third capacitor. So what about the total voltage? Total voltage is equals to the sum of individual voltage, which is V1, V2, V3. Is it clear, everyone? What is our main aim? Our main aim to find out the equivalent capacitance. So what do you mean by equivalent? That means instead of 3 or instead of 4 or instead of 5, whatever be the arrangement, if we use a single capacitance, that is equivalent to all of this. Matlab, main agar bolu ki mujhe 5 aadmi chahiye ek kaam karne ke liye, aur kisi ne bola nahi, tumhe 5 aadmi ka zarurat nahi hai. मैं एक आदमी का नाम बोल रहा हूँ, वही एक आदमी ही काफी है. सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वन आदमी इज इक्विवेलेंट टू दैट पांच आदमी. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द इक्विवेलेंट कैपेसिटी. सो लेट सी इज द इक्विवेलेंट कैपेसिटी ऑफ दिस होल अरेंजमेंट. सो कैपेसिटेंस का फॉर्मूला क्या है? क्यू इक्वल्स टू सी वी. सो वी क्या हो जाएगा? टोटल चार्ज विच इज सेम फॉर ऑल ऑफ देम बाई सी विच इज द इक्विवेलेंट. दैट इज for the first one, same amount of charge flow through this one, this one, this one. Why? Because it's a series arrangement. So Q by C1, Q by C2, Q by C3. So 1 by C, that is 1 by C1, 1 by C2, 1 by C3. For n number of capacitors, 1 by C, this is the series capacitance, so we can write CS. S stands for series. For n number of capacitor, we can write 1 by C1, 1 by C2, dot, 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 1 by CN. And apart from that, if C1 is equals to C2, dot, 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 equals to CN, means all are the same capacitor, let it be C. So what we can have? 1 by CS, 1 by C, 1 by C, up to 1 by C, that is N by C, which means CS is C by N. Is it clear? So dekho, agar mere paas aisa hua ki 5 capacitor same value connected in series, what is the equivalent? C by 5. Is it okay, everyone? You can please note down. Parallel arrangement. After that, write down parallel arrangement. I want to give you one more information. You can write it in important note. Important note that suppose we have two capacitors, so we can write 1 by C series, that is 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So for two capacitors, if we have two capacitors, we can use direct formula, which save our time. Like from here, we can say C1, C2, C1 plus C2. So C series, that is C1, C2, C1 plus C2. Is it okay, everyone? So this one, especially for two capacitors, we can directly use this formula, which will help you in series. Always remember C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. Done? And for resistance, and for resistance, just the reverse thing happened. माने इसका जो सीरीज है रेजिस्टेंस में उसका उल्टा होगा, मतलब ये सीरीज के लिए हो रहा है, रेजिस्टेंस में यही बात पैरेलल के लिए होता है. 1 by R is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. और ये जो रेजिस्टेंस का पैरेलल में होता है वो इसका सीरीज में है, जो रेजिस्टेंस का सीरीज है वो इसका पैरेलल है. ठीक है. सो नाउ द सेकेंड अरेंजमेंट इज पैरेलल अरेंजमेंट. नाउ द सेकेंड अरेंजमेंट इज पैरेलल अरेंजमेंट. So for parallel arrangement, same way, suppose we start with the three capacitor connected in parallel. V is the total voltage, Q is the charge supplied by the battery, same amount of Q received by the battery. But now these are called the node from or junction from which, if you have so many terminals, then this charge is now divided Q1, Q2, Q3 as the capacitance are C1, C2, C3. So this is a very important point, or this one is a key point, if your charge is distributed, then it is parallel connection. If the charge is not distributed, जहां तक charge distribute नहीं होगा, तहां तक charge जो है capacitor जो है series में होगा, जहां distribute होगा फिर वो parallel में हो जाएगा. Are you getting my point?
So it was sideways now.
So now see the total amount of charge supply is Q, and in parallel connection what happened, जो जो टर्मिनल सेम वोल्टेज से कनेक्टेड है, मतलब जो जो टर्मिनल का कॉमन टर्मिनल होगा उसका उसका वोल्टेज भी सेम होगा. सो क्लियरली फ्रॉम हियर क्यू इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन थ्री पार्ट. सो व्हाट वी कैन से, टोटल चार्ज दैट इज द चार्ज बाय द वन बाय द टू बाय द थ्री. नाउ क्यू इज इक्वल्स टू सी वी. क्यू इज इक्वल्स टू सी वी. C is the equivalent capacitance. Let C is the equivalent capacitance, and in parallel connection voltage is same. So C V, that is C1 V, same voltage for all, plus C2 V plus C3 V. So C is C1 plus C2 plus C3. So for n number of capacitor in parallel, P for parallel, last time we use the symbol S in suffix, S for series. Now here we use P in the suffix, the P for parallel. So for n number of capacitors, we can use C1 plus C2 plus C3 dot 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 Cn. Now if C1 plus C1 equals to C2 equals to C3 equals to Cn is equals to C. So C parallel is C plus C up to C, that is Nc. Okay. And here, as it is a simple addition, so you don't need to remember for two capacitor. Okay. But for series, as they are 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2, that is C directly, you can use C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. So you can remember this one. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, up to this, it's okay. Sometime, even in board exam, once or twice, this the arrangement of capacitor in series, arrangement of capacitor in parallel, once asked, and that is a 3 marks question. So don't forget to remember that part because sometimes they ask you the very basic questions also. और अगर हम लोग बड़ा बड़ा questions किया और basic questions को नहीं किया तो भी हम लोगों को कभी कभी problems हो सकता है. So in that time you can use your brain also. The total charge is distributed in three parts. Voltage is constant, so you can derive it easily. Okay? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now after that, अच्छा मैं तुम लोगों को अब मुझे कुछ दिन टाइम दो, समर वैकेशन शुरू होगा, मैं तुम लोगों का ये इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स का खुद का हैंड रिटन नोट बनाना शुरू किया है. तो मैं कल परसों में कुछ पार्ट पूरा तो नहीं हो पाएगा क्योंकि बहुत क्लास हो चुका है, मैं लगभग अभी तक 15-20 पेज का लिखा हूँ. तो जैसे जैसे कंप्लीट होगा मैं तुम लोग को सेंड करने का कोशिश करूंगा, ठीक है? और वो तुम्हारा एकदम फाइनल नोट की तरह यू कैन यूज इट कि मैं एकदम पूरा जितना तरह का पॉसिबिलिटीज हो सकता है सब देखे वो क्वेश्चन नोट्स बना रहा हूँ. ओके नाउ इम्पोर्टेंट नोट सी फॉर एन number of capacitor in -5. I just give you one example, then you understand what I mean from that. Suppose you have arrangement of plates like this, up to n number of plates. Okay, this is plus, this one is minus. And they, if they ask you what is the equivalent capacitance, see, from the previous class, we know if we have a parallel plate capacitor, plate separation D and plate area A, then the capacitance is epsilon naught A by D for each capacitor. We know it from the previous class?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, I just give you one example, then you realize exactly what's happening. Suppose how many plates you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many plates you have? So how many capacitor we expect from here?
5.
Huh?
5.
So check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think you understand.
Yes, sir.
So up to n. Huh? So this type of arrangement is called the series arrangement. Q. Dekho, one terminal is my positive. So this one is positive. Due to that, this terminal is negative. This terminal is positive. This terminal is negative. This terminal is positive. Negative, positive, negative. And the last one is negative. So dekho, plus minus, plus minus, plus minus, plus minus, plus minus. So this is a series arrangement. As this is a series arrangement, so we know for series, same plate area, same separation. So we can write 1 by C, 1 by C, 1 by C, up to, as the number of plate is N, so number of capacitor is N minus 1. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So what we can write, N minus 1 by C, that means C series is 1 by N minus 1 C. And for each capacitance, what is the value? 1 by N minus 1 epsilon naught A by D. Okay. So the second part, I just want to show you the second part of this important note. You can note down. Dear, note korchis to bhalo kore.
Dear. Yes, sir.
Ami kintu tor khata ei bochor 12 hoye gele tor khata take ami as a স্ট্যান্ডার্ড কপি রাখবো, প্রত্যেক বছর আমি একটা করে স্ট্যান্ডার্ড কপি রাখি. হ্যাঁ, আমার কাছে আগে যেমন যে খাতাগুলো থেকে পড়াই সেগুলো কোনো না কোনো ব্যাচের কোনো স্টুডেন্টের কপি যে পড়াই সেটা আমি কি পড়ালাম ওটা থাকে ওখানে. তো এই বছর আমার কিন্তু ইচ্ছা আছে তোরটা রাখবো 12 এর ঠিক আছে ভালো করে কর ওকে নাও হোয়াট হ্যাপেন সি সাপোজ দিস আর দা প্লেটস And this is my one polar ye, and this is the another one. This is the negative plate. So you have one plate positive, you have another plate negative, and you have to find out the equivalent capacitance. You have to find out the equivalent capacitance. So how you find out the equivalent capacitance? Again, if you have n number of plate, So the number of capacitor is n minus 1. And which type of arrangement this is? So this one is parallel arrangement. Why this one is parallel arrangement? How you know this one is parallel arrangement? See, one terminal is positive, another terminal is negative. The last one terminal is positive and it induces plus minus, but here not this thing happened. As this one is positive, so the plate connected with this all are positive is it okay okay hello and this yes. one is negative so all connected with this one see All connected with this one. All are negative. So what we can say? We can say it's such a way it arranged that all positive terminals are in connected with the one terminal. See, all positive are connected with the one terminal, and all negatives are connected with another terminal. Like this. I think I can make it clear. See what's going on. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So which type of arrangement this is? Series arrangement or parallel arrangement?
Parallel.
So as it is a parallel arrangement, sorry, in parallel arrangement we just add them. So what we can write C1, C2, CN. So C plus C. Acha here it is a n minus 1 so c plus n minus 1 that is n minus 1 c so n minus 1 epsilon not a by d okay so this is also the way examiner can ask you question so you can note down that part and then after that we see after that you can write down find equivalent capacitance between A and B for the following. Find equivalent capacitance between the point A and B for the following. Find equivalent capacitance between A and B for the following. So I can start with question number one. So this terminal is A terminal, this terminal is B terminal, capacitor C, 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 C. This is called the find the equivalent capacitance between A and B. My second question is, This point is A, this point is B, C, 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 C. Question number three.
Question number four.
क्वेश्चन
नंबर फाइव सर अलग अलग क्वेश्चन है सब हाँ नंबर मतलब तो अलग ही होता है ना
मेरे को लगा आप ऑप्शन दे रहे हो
ऑप्शन तो एबीसीडी होता है क्वेश्चन नंबर फाइव क्वेश्चन नंबर सिक्स Question number seven. ठीक है उधर में एक जगह बच गया है ना दे दे वहां पे क्वेश्चन हेलो चलो साथी बनाओ पहले I just help you how to solve this type of question. So basically, question number one, question number two, question number three, question number four, question number five, question number six. This six question, you can solve it by the single help or single trick, single help or single trick. By using a single trick, you can solve question number one, question number two, question number three, four, five, and six. And what is that single trick? The trick is that if you have a plain wire, like these are the plain wire, this one is plain wire, this one is plain wire. This was plain wire, this one is plain wire. Here you have plain wire. So whenever you have plain wire, you can suppose them as a single point. I just to give you one example, then you realize it. Suppose this one is your plain wire and you have three capacitors C1. You have capacitor C2 and you have capacitor C3. So this is one point, this is one point, this is one point. Instead of this different points, because these all are connected by the plain wire, means how you understand this is a plain wire? No capacitor in between the points. So you can suppose it as a single point and you can take it like this. Are you getting my point? this thing for different point, you can suppose it as a single point. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So which will help you easily to find out what is the equivalent capacitance. Just I show you the first one, then you try the next, all of them. Okay. I just want to show you one, like this one. See, this is a single point. This, a single point, because only no capacitor is there, only plain wire, conducting wire. This, you can suppose it as a single point. So we can start from A, one capacitor we have. Next, we have two capacitor. This is the next point. And how many capacitor you have? Two capacitors. Next point, this one, how many capacitor you have? Three capacitors. Now, next point, this one, how many capacitor you have? Two capacitor. Next point, how many capacitor you have? C. So we know in parallel arrangement, we add them. So if we start from A, my first capacitor is C. If we start from A, my first capacitor is C. My second capacitor is C parallel. So what we can say? 2C. My next is how much? 3C. My next capacitor, again 2C. And then C, and the point is B. Now clearly it is a series arrangement. What is the formula for series arrangement? 1 by C AB, that is 1 by C plus 1 by 2C plus 1 by 3C plus 1 by 2C plus 1 by C. So what you have, 6C, you can take common. So 6 plus 3 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6. Kitna ho gaya? 6, 3, 9, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 6, 3, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 20 by 6C. So C of AB is 3 by 10C, that is 0.3C. Is it okay, everyone? Now see question number 2. So we have already 2 points, A and B. So now we have terminal. Let it be D, let it be E, let it be F. Everyone, is it okay?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So my concentration on these 2 points, A point and B point. So A is my 1 point, and A to B direct, we have one capacitor. A to B direct, we have one capacitor. So we can take this one. Now, if we see properly, we can find out this B is connected with the D, D is connected with the E, E is connected with the F by the plain wire. So we can say B is equals to D, is equals to E, is equals to F. So now between A and D, we have one capacitor. So 1 point we have A, another point we have D. So we can connect one capacitor. Now, between A and E, we have one capacitor. Between A and F, we have one capacitor. So everyone, guys, you understand? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So how many capacitor you have in parallel?
Four.
So what is your answer?
Four.
Okay. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Hata de isko pe, second wala ko.
Yes, sir.
Second wala. Now, let's try the next one. Now, let's try the next one. Now, in this question, see between A and B. So A and B, you are not able to go direct because there you have some gap. So you can go via from A, you can move O, then from O, you can go there. Let that point is A, B is there, D, that point is E, that point is F. So if you from O, if you reach D, that means automatically you are on the point B because it's a plane wire. So my first point is A, then my second destination is O. Between A and O, we have one capacitor. Now from O to D, my next destination, if I write one capacitor and if I take it, now D and B are the same point. D is connected with the E, same point. E is connected with the F, same point. Now we already choose OA, we already choose OD. So now we have to choose O and E. So for O and E, this is my one point, this is my another point. So we can put it like this. So we take it. Now the next one remain O and F. So we can take it. So all capacitors are picked. That means we marked all capacitors. Now it is clearly visible that one point is A, you have one capacitor. Now these three capacitors are in parallel. So you can write 3C. And then B, we have to find out between A and B. You have two capacitors in series. I can give you in important note, direct formula. If you have two capacitors, so you can write C1 into C2 by C1 plus C2, that is 3 by 4C. Is it clear? We can remove this one also from the book, from board. So this one is also done. Now we are put our concentration on the next question. See, we have one point and you have another point B. In between, you have this one point, and this one point. So we can make it AB as C is also there. So we can make it D point, we can make it E point, we can make it F point. Can we do that? Can we do that?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Now we start our journey from A and my aim to reach at the point B. But before we start journey, I realize that A and E are connected by the plane wire. So we can write A and E are the same point. Is it clear?
Yes.
So that means we can say if we are at A or we are at E are the same meaning. So next from E, if we reach F, my next destination is F. And between E and F, we have one capacitor. So we take it. Now, when we are at F, we realize F and D are connected by the plane wire. So we can say F and D are the same point. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
And now from F to B, we have one capacitor between F and B. So we write it here and we take it. So from A, we reach our destination, but from A to B, when we reach our destination, we realize some capacitor we are not able to take it. So now we
take that left out capacitors, first of all, we can take A and D. Between A and D, you have one capacitor. Is it yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So A is your one point, D is your another point. You have one capacitor. You can make it tick. Now between D and E, your one more capacitor left. Between D and E, your one more capacitor left. So now we tick all capacitor. Now it is clearly visible. These three are in series with this in parallel. So we can say this is the A point. You have three C point. Any point you can say B, F or D. And next point is B, C. Again, you have C of AB, two capacitor in series, CC into C by 3C plus C, so 3 by 4C. Okay. Everyone, is it okay? Everyone, is it okay? टफ लग रहा है कि इजी लग रहा है खुशबू
सर थोड़ा टफ है
नहीं थोड़ा टफ नहीं थोड़ा प्रैक्टिस करना पड़ेगा ये सब सो दिस डन नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 तो देखो दिस इज वन पॉइंट And you can put them. So you can write A, B, let it be D, let it be E, let it be F, E, A, B, C, D, E, F, let it be G. Or yahan pe ek point hai, let it be O. So you can write in that manner, or you can realize it. They are same points. So you can write A also. If you write them in terms of D and E, you can write A is equals to D is equals to O. And your next destination is O. And then from here, you have this B. If you want, you can write B is equals to G. Here you can write A is equals to D is equals to E. Now between D and O, you have one capacitor. D and O, you have one capacitor. Between E and O, you have one capacitor. Between O and F, you have one capacitor. Between O and G, you have one capacitor. Between D and F, you have one capacitor. Between E and G, you have one capacitor. So basically how it looked like, these two are in parallel, these two are in parallel, and then these two are in. So how I can write it? A, these two are in parallel. That is 2C, this point is O, then again 2C, this point is B, in the upper one, you have C, the lower one, you have C. Now 2C and 2C are in series, so two capacitor, two same value of capacitor connected in series, so we divide it by 2. So 2C divided by 2 is C, so what we have, A, B, this one is C, this one is C. This one is C. So basically what happened? 2C to CC, CCC, that is C of AB is CC. Hello? So the next question. See, again, one point is A, another point is B, and we have some terminals. This one, this one, this one. This one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. So A, B, let it be C, let it be D, let it be E, let it be F, G, H, I, J, K. Is it okay, everyone? So we start our journey from A. My first destination is C, and between A and C, I have one capacitor. 8 microfarad. I take it. Now, C and D are the plain wires. So we are at C, that means automatically we are at D also. Now between D and E, we have one capacitor. How much? 2 microfarad. And we are at E, that means we are at F, we are at G, we are at H, we are at I, because this one is clearly visible, a plain wire. So we can write E is equals to F, is equals to G, is equals to H, is equals to I. So these all are the plain wire. So we are at E means we are at F. Now from F, we want to reach B. My next destination, between F and B, we have one capacitor. How much? 4 microfarad. Now B, J, and K are the same point. J and K. Now, after take this one, now we have to see which one we missed out. We missed out C and I. So this is my C point. This is my I point. Between C and I, we have one capacitor, 6 microfarad. Tick. Between D and H, we missed out one capacitor, 2 microfarad. Between G and K, here you have G point, here you have K point, you missed out, or we missed out one capacitor, 5 microfarad. So now we can say, okay, we complete all, or we tick all the capacitors. Now it is very clear that this here in parallel, these two are in parallel, and this here in series. Yes? Hello?
D, H, K, beech mein 3 hai, 2 nahi.
Yes. DNF. Sorry. Ek 3 hai na. So what we can do, A, my next point, you have one capacitor, 8, then 6 plus 3, 9 plus 2, 11, and then we have 9. So now we can make it parallel combination, series, 1 by 8, 1 by 11, 1 by 9. As I just give it randomly the values, so you can LCM it and solve it. That is not my cup of tea. Is it okay, everyone?
Yes.
So after that, the next one, is not a little bit from that one, but the very easy one. Okay, so this one, if I concentrate, or I can do one thing, I can draw it again. A, B. So 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 3, 3, 3. These all are in micro. So see it properly. My main target is find the equivalent capacitance between A and B. So there is a one more way to judge it.
if you connect a battery, so the amount of charge supplied by the battery is always the amount of charge received by the battery. Is it clear? Is it clear? Now see, the charges are distributed like this. If we say Q1, because how many terminals you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terminals from A. Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5. Is it clear? Now see, here you have the same charge, right? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So can we say they are series?
Yes, sir.
Now this one and this one, see, two terminals, two common terminals, and charges are distributed. So can we say they are parallel connection?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now here you have Q1, here you have Q2. So obviously these two are joined and form Q1, Q2.
Yes, sir.
So this total and this one, they are series or parallel?
Series.
Yes, because this total is Q1 plus Q2 and that is also Q1 plus Q2. So this total is series. So you can get the total. Now this one and this one, see, again distributed. This is Q1 plus Q2, this is Q3. So this with respect to this terminal, this is Q3, this total is Q1 plus Q2. So you can say this total and this total are in parallel. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, this one and this one add and it will become Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. So can we say this total and this one in series?
Yes, sir.
Now here you have Q4 and here you have Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. So Q4 and this total is in parallel.
Yes, sir.
Now Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 and plus Q4, and this is also Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. So this the whole with this in series. Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3, yes, plus Q4. So the whole with this in series. And this one and this one, see, Q5 and Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. So they are what connection? Parallel connection. Done. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So now what we can say, these two are in series. What do you mean by series? 6, 6, ja? If it is in series, so divided by 2. So 6, 6, 3. 3 and 3 are in parallel. 3, 3, 6. 6 and 6 are in series. So 3. 3 and 3 are in parallel. 6. 6 and 6 are in series. 3. 3 and 3 are in parallel. 6. 6 and 6 are in series. 3. 3 and 6 are in parallel. So what is your answer? 3 and 6 are in parallel. So what is your answer? 3 plus 6, that is 9 microfarads. Got it? You can say it in another way also. See, tum log bologe sir, likhenge kaise? So you can mark it like this: C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, C8, C9. Now, is it clear that C1 and C2 are in series? So you can say C of 1, 2, that is series. So what is your answer? 6 by 2, you can say 6 by 2, that is 3 microfarad. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes.
Everyone, is it okay? Now this C of 1, 2 with 3, C of 1, 2 and C7 are in parallel.
So what you can write, C of 1 to 7, C of 1, 2 plus C7, that is 3 plus 3, that is 6 microfarad. Means what you can do that, these two are in series, 3 with this parallel, 6. Now this C of 1, 2, 7, C of 1, 2, 7, and C3 are in series. So this hole is how much? 6 with this is series. So what you can write, 6 by 2, that is 3 microfarad, and that is how much? C of 1, 2, 7, 3. Is it clear? Is it clear? Now this hole is parallel with which one? C8. So we can say C of 1, 2, 7, 3 and C8 are in parallel. So you can simply add them, 3 microfarad plus 3 microfarad, that is 6 microfarad. Now this one and this one are in parallel. So what you can say, C of 1, 2, 7, 3, 8, 4 and C9 are in parallel. So 3 plus 3, that is 6 microfarad. And what is its value? C of 1, 2, 7, 3, 8, 4, 9. Is it clear? So this one you also take. Now this one and this one is in series. So you can say now after this. C of C of 1, 2, 7, 3, 8, 4, 9 and C5 are in series. So 6, that is 6 by 2. That is 3 microfarad, which is equals to C of 1, 2, 7, 3, 8, 4, 9, 5. Now this hole is parallel with C6. So after that, this is the first star mark. This is the second star mark. C of 1, 2, 7, 3, 8, 4, 9, 5 and C6 are in parallel. So C of 1, 2, 7, 3, 8, 4, 9, 5, 6. That is the C of AB. That is 6 plus 3. 6 plus 3. That is 9 microfarad. Okay. Adrika.
Yes, sir.
তুমি এখন জয়েন করলে কেন
না না স্যার ডিসকানেক্ট হয়ে গেছিলাম মাঝখানে
ও আচ্ছা সো এভরিওয়ান ইউ ক্যান আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড কি বাই তুম লোগ ইসকো মুজাবানি করোগে তো